So hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Dhruv here from PlusDrive. Hope you guys are doing absolutely fine. So today I'm going to review this particular car, the Renault Duster 2019 variant. This particular car is the facelift variant of the first generation Renault Duster. It looks more bold and muscular. So if you're new to the channel, please subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any amazing content. So with that said, let us just start with the video. So yes, this is the 2019 Renault Duster, the facelift variant of the first generation, which is available in four variants: RXE, RXS, RXS optional and RXZ. The particular car which you're seeing over here, this is RXZ, which is the top end variant in this line. And also guys, this particular car is available in seven interesting color options, which are cayenne orange, moonlight silver, slate gray, outback bronze, pearl white, and the two new colors are added is caspian blue, mahogany brown. So those were the seven interesting color options in this particular vehicle. So now guys, if you ask me what are the difference between the first variant and this facelift variant, so this new Duster comes with a superior SUV capabilities and more enhanced features. In terms of design, it is more sharp, bold and muscular even, and also some cosmetic changes. If you compare to the previous variant, you get skid plates and all. In this particular vehicle, the design is more sharp, it looks more muscular, the huge wheel arches and all. So the body, all over the body structure is more solid build and the quality is even better. So now guys, getting back to the front profile, first thing you'll see the tri-wing full chrome grill over here in the front, three chrome insert grill and a huge Renault logo across that. You get a black piano finish which is perfectly synced with the this signature projector headlamps over here, and also you get a LED DRLs on the lower side, which is a new, absolutely new headlamp assembly if you compare to the previous variant, which looks absolutely great and gives a very bright visibility in the night. Then on the lower side guys, you get a this fog lamp. These are conventional fog lamp, not the LED one or the projector fog lamp. And also you get a chrome insert plating just above the fog lamps to give it a more superior look and more robust look. So, and also guys, in the front you will get this silver insert skid plates on the lower side, which comes standard across all the variants. So this was not there in the previous variant. And also I really like this silver insert guard over here in the front, which looks absolutely muscular, gives the car very muscular look and very, I mean, the overall the design is very appealing in the front. Then the same headlamp assembly on the left side and as well as the fog lamp on the lower side. And also guys, it will look more balanced from all four sides in terms of design. I really like this huge wheel arches, which gives the car very muscular look, and the crease on the bonnet, which you'll see. I really like these bonnet crease. Again, very height, the hood is on the height also. It gives the car very, again, muscular look, and the design is very dominating from the front. It looks more towards the, I mean, a true SUV feel you'll get over here on the front part of the particular vehicle. So this is the side profile of the huge wheel arches what you're getting in this particular vehicle. Absolutely, it looks mind-boggling. Now guys, talking about the tire size and specification, you're getting 215 section 65 R16 Everest diamond cut alloy wheels in this particular vehicle, which looks absolutely great. And also guys, lower guard is in silver insert, you get just below the doors. And also guys, in the front you get the disc brake, and in the rear you get the drum brakes. Then this is the RXZ badging on the front fender. Now talking about the ORVMs, you get electronically adjustable ORVMs with turn indicators on them, which are electronically retractable as well, with dual tone black and Caspian blue color. Then on the top guys, you get a roof rail, sporty roof rails, which Renault likes to call it the kayak roof rails. The term is kayak roof rails. And also this was the side profile of the car. Now talking about some dimension, I really like this plate on the window line, which looks absolutely great, gives a nice character to the vehicle from the side profile as well. Now guys, talking about some dimension of the vehicle, the length of the car is 4360 mm, the width is 1822 mm, the height is 1695 mm, and the ground clearance is 205 mm. Now guys, talking about some suspension system, front you get the independent McPherson strut with coil spring, and rear you get the tailing up with coil spring and double acting shock absorber, for which the ride quality will be more even smoother and even better. So this is a chrome plate on the character line you're getting, which looks absolutely great from the side profile as well. Then on the lower guard you get silver insert plate in this particular vehicle, I guess, which is the standard across all the variant. Then this is the fuel tank over here, sorry, the fuel lid. Under that you have the 50 liters of fuel tank, for which the company claims the mileage of 19.6 kmpl. then this is the rear profile of the tire, 215 section 65R16 Everest diamond cut alloy wheels. The Renault likes to call it the Everest diamond cut alloy wheels. Then this is the rear profile of the car. First thing, you get the wheel arches at the back also guys, for which the car looks even muscular. And also I have told you regarding the suspension, so this is the rear profile. Now coming to the rear profile guys, so the rear profile will be almost similar to the particular vehicle. I really like this design, besides the tail lamp. So first thing, you get the defoggers over here and the high stop rear mount lamp. Then this is the rear washer wiper. Then on the lower side, only two cosmetic changes guys. Then this is a washer wiper, yes. Then below on the side you get a wiper. And also guys, this duster plating, this is new, which is called the embellisher and which is in matte black. So it looks new, and the Renault logo is in the center, so this particular thing is new. Then on the lower left side you get the Renault badging in chrome insert, as well as this. The second change in this particular vehicle is this waterfall tail lamp, the LED waterfall tail lamp, which looks absolutely great. And it gives a very nice visibility in the night as well. Then on the lower side, the new thing, which is this Duster, has come up with the rear skid plates, the SUV skid plate guys. Then this is the right side profile of the tail light on the back side. Then also on the lower side guys, you get the this parking sensors, the rear parking sensors. Also guys, just below the tail lamps you get the reflectors on this particular vehicle, and also the rear skid plates, which is in again silver insert. The you get a nice silver insert skid plates. Then these are the reflectors on the right as well as on the left side, and also the rear towing hook over here. And also you get a integrated diffusers in this particular vehicle. The spare wheel is in the on the lower side, which is again a R16 inch stainless steel tire, not the diamond cut alloy wheel. Then this is the rear towing hook, and also you get the exhaust pipe on the left side of the vehicle. So overall rear profile, yes, this is the rear towing hook available on the lower right side. So overall the rear profile of the car looks absolutely dominating, just like the front, it looks more muscular and all. Now guys, talking about some safety and technology of this particular vehicle, the new Duster, it offers you a monocoque design with true SUV features like hill start assist, ESP, along with the comfort features like cruise control, help, make any adventure effortless. It also comes with a dual airbag, speed alert, seat belt reminder and ABS to keep you safe. So build quality and safety features are on the top. Renault has taken proper care. Now talking about the interior guys, this is the door trim over here. You get a nice silver insert handlebar, the grab handlebar, which looks absolutely great. It is in glossy finish, and the plastic is towards the higher side, not the cheap one. You also get a dual stitching armrest on the door trim itself. Then the seat pocket door pockets are over here. Then these are the controls for ORVMs and window controls. The handlebar is in chrome insert. Then on the lower left side you get a speaker system. You get a nice decent amount of door pocket I mean, it could have been much, but not even a 1 liter, you get a 500 ml bottle storage, I guess, on the door pockets, which is less if you compare to the other cars. Then this is the front cabin look, guys, which the Renault likes to call it the midnight black interiors. It does not have the smart key access card. You have to just put on the keys over here. And also, guys, the interior looks very nice and bright. The seats qualities are very good. You get a dual stitching and also you get some kind of patterns on the seat itself. And also the seats are very soft cushioned. The lombard support and the under thigh support is good on this particular vehicle. The under thigh support could have been better. And also this is the armrest, which is a very short type of armrest. It could have been better. I mean, very not a big, but a big armrest, which will be even useful for the passenger as well. Then the seats are manually adjustable, not electronically. Now as inside the car, the seats are comfortable. I mean, it is a good comfortable seat, perfectly synced in. You get a nice under thigh support and the lower back support is good. Then this is the three spoke steering wheel, guys, which is leather wrapped steering wheel. You get a silver insert across the steering wheel with the soft buttons on them, and also a Renault logo in the center of the steering wheel, which is manually adjustable only for the rake, not for the reach. But a good option again over here, I mean good feature again over here. Then this is the instrument cluster, guys, which is analog tachometer as well as the speedometer. Then on the right side you get a MID display where you'll see the temperature setting and all the vehicle settings you'll be seeing over there, distance to empty and everything. And also across the instrument cluster you get a chrome garnish insert, which again gives a premium look to the car, premium finish to the car. Then again on the AC vents, guys, you get the silver insert what was on the grab handle of the door trim, which looks absolutely premium, feels premium, guys. Also, guys, one thing forgot to add on the steering wheel part, you get the nice soft buttons available on both the side with some infotainment controls, and on the left side you get the light controls and also turn indicator controls. On the right side, guys, you get the wiper controls. And also on the lower side you get the voice command, source audio system and call accept and decline and mode button on the lower side, which I totally forgot to show you before. So now getting back to the steering wheel, guys, it looks very rigid, very nice to hold, and the quality is overall very nice towards the premium side. The interior feels very spacious and very roomy. This is the dashboard look, guys. I mean, you get a nice a plastic, not towards the cheap side. You get lot of inserts like blue, black piano finish through the center console and towards the armrest and everything on the lower part, even the gear knob and everything. So this is the black piano finish you're getting in full center console, even in this cup holders on the lower side. Then this is the glove box on the lower side, guys. You get a nice glove box light also inside. This is a cool glove box. And also in this particular vehicle, you get a Duster badging on the dashboard itself with SRS badging, the airbags badging. Then also you get a blue insert, the Caspian blue insert on the dashboard itself. Also, guys, this car offers you a nice black piano finish and also the chrome insert across the AC vents, which again gives the premium look, the hazard button, then the lock button. Then this is the infotainment screen, guys, which supports Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, AUX, USB, and also this voice command system, which looks absolutely great. The quality of touch is very nice. It is nice sensitive touch, and also it does not lag and everything. So these are the some controls. You get navigation, you get media player, or Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, and everything you get in this particular vehicle. And also, guys, I would like to remind you that in this particular vehicle you also get a SRS airbags. I mean, in the front, on the sides you get the SRS airbags. Then this is the Bluetooth receiver. Just below that you get a USB and AUX option on the screen itself. Then this is a cruise control button over here. Then this is a Bluetooth receiver, and this is the dummy button on the left. Then this is the automatic climate control on the lower side, guys. You get a nice dials. You get a chrome garnish insert across the dials, which looks absolutely great and feels very premium towards the nice quality side. Then on the lower side, guys, you get a 12V charging socket, and also it offers you the eco button. Then some storage to keep your space for, but you can definitely fit something over there. Then just behind that you get the two size cup holders, which is absolutely great. Then you get a nice 6-speed manual transmission, gearbox over here, the gear knob, which looks great. And you get a silver insert gear knob top, which looks again great. Then on the lower side, guys, you get a nice black piano finish across the center console on the lower side as well, which again, guys, it's giving a very nice premium touch to the car on the center console as well as on the dashboard. Then the chrome tip handbrake you get over here, not the plastic one, but the chrome tip again gives a very nice premium look to the car and even feels very, the quality is lush and rich. Then the seats are very soft cushioned, a nice under thigh support as well, guys. Then over here on the top, regarding the sun visors, guys, you get the toll receipt holder. You don't get a vanity light or vanity mirror. But on the passenger side, guys, you get a vanity mirror, but no vanity lights. Then on the top, guys, you get the cabin lights over here and also a Bluetooth receiver on the left side. Then this is the manually adjustable rear view mirror, not the auto dimming rear view mirror. So, which could have been the auto dimming, in this price range. Also, I'll tell you regarding the prices. So overall, interior, guys, looks very spacious. It looks, not drastic changes if you compare to the previous variant, guys. You get a nice chrome handlebar, some cosmetic changes, and even the interior is more refined. You get a lot of inserts like black piano finish and silver insert and everything. So this was about the front cabin, guys. Now let us just talk about the rear cabin and see what the car has to provide us in terms of space, how comfortable it is in the rear cabin. So first thing, the same door trim I'll start with over here. You get a nice brownish pad on the just beside the armrest and with dual stitching, and the plastic is towards the top side, not the cheap plastic. On the lower side, you also get a chrome handle latch, and also on the lower side you get a nice speaker system. Then no door pockets in the rear, which is towards the disappointing side, but it could have been better with the door pockets as well. Then this is the rear cabin view, which looks spacious. Three people can easily sit, as this is a 5-seater SUV. And also, guys, for the middle passenger as well, you get a headrest, and also you get an armrest in this particular vehicle. Then this is a partial tray at the rear, which I'll show you from the rear as well. Then also on the back seat, you get the patterns on the seat itself. The seat feels very comfortable in the front. Now let us just check it out on the rear side. So the seats are pretty comfortable. It is towards the decent size, guys, decent side. Then this is the knee room available for this vehicle, and you get the seat pockets on the driver side as well as on the passenger side, guys. It looks nice, and the hump is very low, so three people can easily go on a long drive or a road trip. So three people can easily sit over here, and also it gets a ISOFIX child seat mounts on the rear side. Then this is the armrest with two cup holders, so a nice a decent size of cup holders at the rear. Then also you get a headrest for the back passenger, then manually adjustable headrest for all three passengers at the rear. Then this is the cabin lights on both the side, which I really like this feature. In multiple vehicles you only have it in between. Then the grab handle on both the sides, which looks not retractable, they are fixed. Then this is the headroom, guys. It looks good. I'm 5'8", so I'm quite comfortable with the headroom as well as the knee room. Under thigh support is great on this vehicle. And also, guys, one thing I'd like to add on, you get a 12V charging socket for the rear passenger on the right side. So a nice thing, not in the center console part. Then this is the dashboard look. So instead of giving in the center console, they have given it on the back side. So nothing to worry, it will come in the between the legs and all the wiring and all. So a good nice feature on the back side on the partial tray, just below, it's besides the partial tray. So this was about the rear cabin, guys. Now let us just check out the boot space and the main part, which is the engine part of the car. So first thing, I'll just give you the boot space, what the boot space the car is providing you, and what are the features in the boot the car is providing you. So let us just check it out. So guys, simply to open the tailgate, you just have to push this button, just key button on the top. So over here, guys, you're getting a massive size of 475 liters of boot space, guys, which is massive and I guess the best in segment, the boot space you're getting in this particular vehicle. I mean, that is a huge boot space, guys. So guys, easily 3 to 4 suitcase and duffel bags and easily fit in this particular boot space was this car is providing us. Then also you get a partial tray on the top, which gives a feel like a premium car. Then also some space to keep your tools and everything just below. Then on the lower side over here, nothing, because the spare wheel is on the lower side. So that is a huge boot space, guys. Then also you get a grab handle on the tailgate. You can just simply access the tailgate from the inside of the vehicle. The seats are divided into 60-40 partially, and you also get a partial tray, which is again a very nice feature. So this is about the tailgate, I mean the boot space, interior, exterior. Now let us just get into the main part, which is the engine part, guys. So to open the engine, you just have to simply pull this lever on the right side, on the driver's side. So this car particularly is offering you 1500cc 4-cylinder common rail direct injection DCI diesel engine. Guys, it is producing 108 bhp at 4000 rpm and 245 nm of torque at 1750 rpm. That is huge. And also you get the hydraulic struts in this particular vehicle, which is again a very nice feature for the, I mean, that heavy, what do you call, the panel of the engine bay you need to hold up. So you get a hydraulic struts, and every engine components are neatly organized. They are full black, and also the battery and everything is on the right side. On the left side you get the engine compartment, and also everything is neatly organized. You get a nice space also to lean and check out any breakdown, anything. So everything is neatly ergonomically organized in the engine bay. Also you get an insulation on the top to decrease the engine noise into the cabin, which will again is a very nice feature towards the, I mean you can say towards the feature side only, not towards the safety feature side. And also guys, one good thing about Renault Duster is it is available in petrol and diesel both, and automatic, and as well as in the manual transmission. And also it offers you a 1.5 liter 85 PS horsepower engine, which is the 5-speed manual transmission. So everything is available, you can check it out on the numbers. And also I would like to thank Benchmark Renault Vashi at Navi Mumbai for allowing me to review the vehicle. You can just I'll provide the number, you can speak to the person over there regarding this particular vehicle, any details you want. So how did you like the car, guys? Leave your thoughts in the comment section below. And also, what do you feel about the car? So also subscribe to the channel, follow me on Instagram, the links will be mentioned on your screen. So bye guys, take care, see you next time for another video. Bye guys.